If you've seen the movie Jurassic Park, one of the very first scenes in the desert where they have the big, beautiful dinosaur skeleton that's all perfectly articulated and they're just digging some dust out, it's almost never like that in real life.
This is such a complicated project because of how you have to get into the site.
We're in a remote location here. It's at least 45 minutes to the bottom of the hill. So we are looking at a potential helicopter rescue if there's anything serious.
It takes a lot of faith and a lot of trust, and it is a very dark and deep hole.
Since there's no other way to get in, you have to rappel in on a single rope, and then you have to ascend out using hand ascenders and your own steam.
Located northeast of Lovell in the Bighorn Mountains, Natural Trap Cave was first explored by paleontologists during the 1970s, but has since been sealed by the Bureau of Land Management to preserve the remaining fossils. Today, with the development of new paleontological methods and techniques, including the discovery of ancient DNA, there's been renewed interest in Natural Trap Cave. In 2014, Dr. Julie Meacham began a three-year expedition with a new team of scientists and volunteers to collect pristine fossils and other organic material they'll use to get a better understanding of Wyoming's past.
Natural Trap Cave is a really important fossil site, not only because of the quantity of fossils that are coming out, but also because of the preservation of the fossils. This site can really inform us of not only changes in genetic variability in the animals, but also of the environment in northern Wyoming during the last ice age. In terms of fossil material, we're looking for diagnostic pieces. We need to be able to identify the species that it came from and the body part that it came from.
It's in three pieces.
Oh, it's in three pieces. Wow.
But they're well-fitting pieces.
They are. This is another proximal metapodial of a cat.
When we have a lot of people down here as a team leader, my job is basically to run around and manage everybody, help the volunteers identify specimens.
Nice, that's definitely a carnivore. Looks like a wolf, yeah.
When you're digging for fossils, most of the time you don't find anything. You're just digging through all the dirt, and all you're finding is more dirt and rocks. But when you see a piece of bone sticking out of the ground, that's extremely exciting.
So see how it's broken right there? So what I'm trying to do is not break that more, so I have to be very careful when I'm taking the rocks out.
The biological gold are the teeth. So we can really identify species very easily from their teeth.
So that, I mean, maybe even could be a tooth. We'll see once I dig up the ends. So there's that little tooth there.
After the fossils have been dug out of the cave, the work truly begins. Eight lead scientists in eight different but related fields will attempt to correlate all of their respective data to build a complete picture of what the Wyoming environment looked like before the large animal extinction event of 13,000 years ago. Their findings will hopefully give scientists a better understanding of how the past shaped our current environment and what that can tell us about the future.
So we all know that the cheetah in Africa is the fastest land mammal, and the pronghorn in North America is a close second. And that's sort of been a conundrum to scientists. Why might this be? Why is there this extremely fast ungulate in North America when there's really not a lot of predators that are fast enough to catch it? And the reason we think that might be, although it's not proven, is the American cheetah-like cat. The morphology of this cheetah, or body form of this cheetah-like cat, looks very much like the African cheetah. It's very tall, it's very long, and it likely was very fast. So this may have been a species that preyed specifically upon the pronghorn antelope.
How does this relate to what's happening today? In Africa, for example, we have the imminent extinction of rhinoceroses, and we have elephants that are very endangered. And so what do we expect to see in that type of community? And there is some evidence that in North America, as you have mammoths going extinct, then what you end up seeing is a real expansion of forest systems because they're no longer being controlled by the megafauna that are on the landscape.
The cave has already begun to provide a clearer picture of the past. As Julie and her team publish the results of their research, the scientific community will have an opportunity to further update the Paleolithic record. The fossils themselves will find a new resting place in a collection at the University of Wyoming, where digital files for 3D printable models will be made available to the public. The sealed cave will continue to preserve its treasures for the next generation of scientists, who will apply new technologies to recover even more information, advancing our understanding of the natural world we inhabit.